everyone. Good day to everybody, sisters, brothers, friends, and the ones who's passing by. Hello, this is Pastor Yeri. Walk with God today, a new study for the coming week or the time. It's on yours how to use this study. Today in our meditation, in our study, we're going to talk about how to really communicate with God. If you want to have a better relationship with God, it must be intentional. Matthew 6, verse 9 to 13. This then is how you should pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Communication in life is more important than we think. Without communication, we would have no relationships. I know where there are days when this sounds like a good thing. However, a good reminder of how miserable it would be with no one else in your life. And I'm not talking about people who don't have a partner. This is about relationships and how you really can communicate with God. God designed us to have relationships and to communicate with Him and each other. True communication does mean audible words. To communicate well with God, you need to know how on a deep level. This isn't just by listening to sermons on Sunday. When you really put Him first by taking time to know Him through His Word, prayer, and His Holy Spirit, you will know and have the Father's heart. If you want a deep relationship with God, it must be intentional. Only by opening up your heart to Jesus, by laying out your hopes, hurts, feelings, and deep things in you, can you build a much closer relationship with Him. He is committed to and an intimate relationship with you. The best way to know and walk with God, as Enoch did, is to read His letter to us, the Bible, and pray by being real with Him. Pour your heart out to God. Don't just be superficial, because He wants to love you on a deep level. Take time to be quiet and listen so you learn to hear Him and know how deeply. His still, small voice will bring peace and direction into your life. True relationship requires time together. So be sure to open up to Him daily. And these are the elements of any truly deep and meaningful relationship with God or anyone else in your life. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, I love you. I don't just want things from you. I want to know you deeply I want to know, and I want to pray as David prayed, not just words, but from the heart. I believe in you, and know that you are with me always. I want to walk with you daily, day by day, and moment by moment. Speak to me. Show me more of you, Lord. My heart is open and I commit to know more. Amen. I have some questions for you. How well do you know God's heart? Receiving this question, it will be very advisable to take it from me to study the life of David, to study our ancestors in the Old Testament and also in the New, like Daniel. There are so many more women in the Bible who really had a deep relationship with God. So how well do you open up your heart to God? And how has God spoken to you in the past? When is the last time you heard God speak? Do you build godly, loving relationships with anyone else? Think about your closest relationship here on earth. What makes it so close? Think about the amount of time you spent with this person. And I have to add to this that in this pandemic and across the world, we have rules for our safety. So maybe for some, you can see each other on a regular basis in person. The other ways is online. And that is as much intensive as you meet in person. So never take this down as a much lower level. It is the act you do in the relationship that can build a relationship. Think about the amount of time you spend with this person, how frequently your communication, how open you are with him or her, and how well you know each other's likes and dislikes. Also consider what situations and experiences have helped you get so close. Make a list of the top 5 things that have helped you grow close. It may have been dedicating time to talk, praying for each other, helping each other through life struggles against each other. Or whatever else comes to mind, is your relationship with Jesus closer than that human relationship? Take the 5 things to help you build that human relationship and prioritize. Then based on the greatest impact to help you grow close. For the next 5 weeks, make a plan on how to use each of these to build your relationship with Jesus. if your relationships are built in Christ, it's always good to reflect. We have relationships in the world, if I may use this word, because they are. Not all are following Christ. Do we have to sign off of those relationships? Not at all. It's the way we live our lives with them. So, let you be encouraged by hearing this, how we really can communicate with God and also through our person-to-person relationships with brothers and sisters, with dear friends, and with other people, like, for example, our work, the people who knows you as a Christian, who are not. So this is all very important. I wish you a wonderful time to think, to write down what really matters, and really make it serious to reflect on your relationships. And God bless you, and have a wonderful day. God bless. Bye.